exchange framework, that name itself depends what it will do. But why Sitecore especially was created the module? Like, we can create our custom code, right? So what's special in that? Before we start in that, let's have just 1 or 2 minutes. So what's special in that is, as like a Sitecore classical way, everything is a Python. And it is not bound out to any like field. Like, as in Sitecore, everything is a template. Okay? So like first name, last name, images, description or something. So here, like, everything is like, you need to like not target a particular field name. Instead of that, you need to target a particular field type. You need to write a generic code. So everything's a pipeline. So if you write for one thing, you can keep reusing things. I can show you the demo and other things. So whatever you told, it is right. It is a like extract, transform, and loop in simple way. So that we are calling it as a data exchange framework. So the table of contents is, first let's discuss about the DXF architecture. Then what are the elements? By default, this module is having some structure is giving so that we can reuse it. What are the things? And next, let's go for a case study. And we had extended the logs also. Okay, so if you see here, DXF, what is DXF? Just we discussed, it is extract, transform, and load. Can you go to the next slide? So in this sample, we are going to discuss about the source will be XML and the target will be Sitecore. So we are going to extract data from the XML, okay, and we are going to load to a particular template in the Sitecore. Okay. Okay. So this is the architecture of the DXF. Okay. So DXF, it requires, there is a source and there is a target. So if there is a source, there are some technical words in this module, like endpoints, accessors, mappings, tenants, value accessors, and the target system. So endpoint is nothing but like, what is the endpoint? Source endpoint and target endpoint. So like it is like a classical ASP.NET other things, connection string, where we are going to target. So source endpoint will be XML. Next. Okay. And the target endpoint will be a Sitecore. Can you go to next? Okay. So source endpoint, source system and source endpoint both are same. It is just for architecture we have shown this. So what is value accessor? So value accessor is something but like XML, we have everything is a nodes. Okay, there's a node name will be there. Probably what other things will be there? You'll have attribute or we have directly will have the values. So that each and everything first we need to define that XML, what are the nodes we are going to extract and what are the places we are going to update it. So that field we need to, like in this sample we had used XPath query, XML XPath query. So each node we need to create a separate item, we need to give XPath query, okay? So that it will be like we have created our custom XML provider. So that XML provider, the XPath query will be passed, it will extract data from the XDoc object until you return back to the Sitecore, .NET memory. Then we go to that. Okay. So XML node to be extracted and processed. I can show you that screen so that you will, this is a high level, let's discuss in detail also. Can you go to next, please? Okay, so the source data also XML. Okay, so there is a technical word called context. So context is the one like, here everything is a pipeline, right? So there is a need will be there. Like you need to process the data and some of the data you need to share between the pipelines. Okay, so here there is a concept called context. Using the context, you can able to pass data between the pipelines. Next, please. Okay, mapping. Okay, what is mean by mapping? Okay,
so I have a question here. Yeah. So is it like passing the data between the pipelines or is it between the processes?
Pipelines. Here everything is a pipelines. Okay.
So in XML, source endpoint will just give the file path of where the XML is there?
Two things. First, we need to give the file path, where is the file to be processed, okay? Then, in that one more thing we need to do is, it will have multiple nodes will be there, right?
Yeah.
Like one parallel node will be there. In the current example, what you're having is, there are three kind of products will be there, like parent SKU family, dual SKU family, and single SKU means parent product, sub product, and sub product. Okay, so we need to process the set of data in a separate manner. Like first we need to process the first level, second level, third level, because we need to make a relationship. right? So if you are taking all the things in a memory, that will be a load for the memory. So we need to pass that unique identifier, okay? XML physical path as well as what we are going to process, that is XPath. Good. Okay, target default is, I told like it is a Sitecore, and the target value accessor is Sitecore fields to be updated. Next. Okay, so target object is like, again, it is a sticker, like high level structure we have. Can you go to next? Okay, logging. So logging is the one by default log format is used, we are using, but our specific requirement is like, we need to add extra logs, like more details, so that any, because our data can be any format, right? Sometimes like we may face encoding issue. We need to know what data is processed, what data is not processed, what time it processed, what got failed, what is the item ID, what is the node, everything. By default, log format, it won't have that much detail. So what we have done is we have extended that logs so that we can customize whatever the information we want and we can able to log it in our own structure. Okay, can you go to next? Yeah, so, okay. So this is that, that's just I told. Okay, this is the structure, high level structure. So data exchange, this by default when you're installing the data exchange framework, you will get this particular node. On top of that, you can create a, I can show you in the screen is blurred. On top of that, you can create a tenant. Okay, what do you mean by tenant? Okay, so, okay, what do you mean by tenant? So this is called tenant. Tenant is nothing but a group of functionalities. Like in this demo, in this session, we are going to discuss about three different things. So we have a product, we have a category, we have an asset, like images. All things will come as a XML. So we need to process separately, right? So if you are clubbing everything, it is tough to manage, to maintain it. So we are like categorizing, okay, I have a separate tenant that will process only product. Post that category, post that asset, right? So that we are calling as a tenant. Endpoint is the one which I told that we'll mention what is the source and target connections, like what we are going to, where we are going to extract and where we are going to update it. Data objects. So data objects is the one like, what are the data we are going to update, like image or like a multi, rich text field or a single text field or like multi-list field, drop link, what kind of data we need and what you are going to update in what format. That is called data objects. So value accessors, like we will mention that XPath query. If it is XML item, if it is a Sitecore, we are going to mention what is the field name where we are going to update it. Okay, mapping is the one, there is, this is the one like we need to tell, okay, this is the source, that is a source item and this is the target item, XML source item and target item. Can you go to next? Okay, pipelines. Okay, pipeline is the one like here in Sitecore as usual, like pipelines, it is a like full of collection of different functionalities. Like first we need to read XML, there is a pipeline. After read XML, we need to convert, from that XML we need to create extract object. From the object we need to pass that whatever the node query, XPath query. We need to extract only the data and again like everything is a pipeline. I'll show you in bio. Pipeline context is the one, just to explain, you need to pass any data, you need to pass between the pipelines, you can able to use it. And the pipeline batch is nothing but a collection of pipelines. Okay, collection of pipelines means like that we will mention what are the pipelines and what is the sequence it is going to execute it. So this I can show it in the real time. Okay, case study. Okay, so this is the thing we are going to discuss. So there is an apparel company. Okay, the current product information is they are meeting in the product information system. Okay, so like in typical like very good like top clients, they won't mingle their product information with CMS. They have a separate system will be there to maintain their catalog information and product information, like e-commerce. Okay, so that they want to export to Sitecore. Why? Because they need to present it in the our end user website. Okay, so that PIM system, they want to like need to import to Sitecore. So the PIM product information system will export the data, whatever they are maintaining in a XML format. With some relationship, like what is the relationship, how the product will come under which category, and what are the assets are need to be tagged for the particular product, and what is the connection between the product and sub-products, like product and sub-product means variants, like if you are taking a shirt, the variant will be like colors, size, we will call it as a child items, right? for those relationships. So these are the types of XML. Okay, what are the use case we are going to discuss is, like, first we need to identify when you are causing an item, the item should be created under which item, relationship, like the product should come under which category. Okay, before creating first, what we need to check, the product is already available in the content tree or not, right? Not product, any item, else it will be a duplicate item, right? First we need to check whether the item is available. If yes, we need to update the what is the change happened. If not, we need to create it. Okay, then if the item is available, then we have to set the workflow. Okay, there is one more requirement we got is, like, if the item is in approved state, okay, if the item is in approved state, we need to create a new version and set back to the draft state. Okay, if not, we need to just update the current version. Why? If you are not doing, then we will load the workbox. Workbox has a lot of duplicate items, right? So this is one of the use cases. Can you go to next? Okay, this is a sample product table, template structure, like ID, template, description, images, Twitter, products. And this is a child item, as I told, like variants. Like, if you are taking as a sure, variant is a size, different things. Okay. So before go to the slides, I will exactly show you the screen, how it looks like, what are the things. So, when you are installing a DXF module, so it will come under a system folder. Okay. So when you are installing a DXF module, you will get this particular node. So on top of it, you can right click and you can able to create a new empty instance. Already for sample things, I have created multiple things. So let's go on. Take one and let's discuss more. So there is a product. For product, I created a separate tenant. Okay, so this is the default structure you will get. You don't need to create anything manually. Like, this particular structure will be created by default when you are creating a new tenant. So what is this file folder? Okay, so this is unused as of now. I have not used it. So this is the one we discussed, data access. Data access, the one we need to mention, like, so this is the XPath query, as I told, right? So this is the XPath query we need to mention, like, what this XML structure. Let's go, let's discuss this. Okay, this is the XML structure. Okay, there is a product. The product has certain attributes, like ID, what is the user type, what is the parent ID. Parent ID means this particular product should come under where. And these are like sub nodes, like attributes, like what is that category name is linked for this, and what are the associated or related products are linked to the particular product, and what are all the assets are linked to the thing. So this is the XML structure. For that, we need to first process the things, and we need to, let's take an example. If I want to store this name field, I need the XPath query, right? I was under this particular node, so I need to put a dot slash of name, so I will get this data. So that is the XPath query we are giving here. Okay, just we need to give the XPath query. So how many how in the XML, how many attributes you need? You need to create a separate items under XML feed provider, like after sales, after copy, body copy, what is the brand, category name, everything you need to create a separate item, and just you need to go and update the XPath query here. So once you are done with that, the same like that, we need to come and create for Sitecore also. In Sitecore, what we need to do now, we have the we know in XML what is the node we need to go into read. Now we need to inform DXF, like, which is a target field we need to go and update the data, right? So here, if you see here, name, we go to the simple thing, name. So this is the name field which we are going to update it. So Sitecore by default, it is giving, there are certain, like if you see the icon, this single icon, these are all the by default plain fields. We don't need to write any extra code. Sitecore is already having the processor and other things that it will take the data and it will store it. You don't need to write the things. But there are some complex structures like related products. You need to do, you need to apply your own logic, how to extend it. That's the thing we are going to discuss right now. So if you see here, there is an example sample here, if I show on the code. List field accessors. So list field accessors, there is a requirement we got is like, there are five products are associated with a particular product, okay? First time we are, when we are importing. So second time we are getting one more requirement, like not requirement, delta field, okay? There is seven products. Again, two more products they are adding. But in the meantime, content author went and reordered something, okay? So the requirement is like, you don't need to, you need to maintain the whatever the reordering, okay? You should not overwrite the existing things. So that customization came. So we need to write our own processor and the converter, take the data, process it. If you see here, so this we are calling it as a converter. So the converter is the one, whatever we are declaring here in this particular template, this converter is a class that can help you to read what are all the values you have created, like what is the field name, is there is any special character we need to ignore it. If in the XPath query, if you want to process more than one query, like there are some requirement we got, like we need to process more than one our type of field, and we need to combine the data and we need to store the data. So all the things we can, there is a converter, we need the converter, we will get the thing. So this is the way of reading the fields of the particular template. So we will get the data, that converted data we need to pass to a writer. This is a writer. So here is the one we will write our own logic. So what we will do is here this target object will get the data from the XML, and this XML data we will process here, like we will split by pipe separator. Let's take an example, if it's a multi-list, we will get the unique IDs. So we need to take the existing data and what all the delta feed, new feed is coming, that we will take and we need to append it and we need to store it here, the field values. So this everything dynamically it will come. If you are, whatever you are mentioning the field name, that's what I told, like you don't need to target a particular field name. Instead of that, you need to target a field type. If we are targeting, like we are writing a separate converter for an image field, that image field can able to use for multiple fields. What are the things in a same template or different template, right? So this is called value access sets. And endpoints, as I explained you, we need to mention what is that source endpoint. This is called Sitecore. Default it is giving, yes, there is a customization here. And this is the target endpoint. So in the target endpoint, the best thing, Manish Agarwal asked some question like where I need to update the XPath query. So this is the XPath query. So this XPath query, if you see, this is a unique identifier of a similar type of XML nodes. So that we can, from the XPath object, we can able to read only those what we need actually. Okay, in real-time scenario, we got a requirement like around 15,000 products will come at one single feed. So it's not wise to store all the things in a memory and to process the data, right? So what we need, let's extract it using the XPath query. Take the data, put it in the memory, and read one by one using the DXF framework, update in the format what we need. Okay, and this is called pipeline batch. So pipeline batch is nothing but it is a collection of pipelines. Okay, if you see here, so here we will mention what are the pipelines that need to be executed in a, what is the order. Like first we need to read the attributes, read all fields, map the fields. Again, like it is for a child, this particular thing is used for multi-level. So the same pipeline is used. We need to just change the XPath in the pipelines. And these are the list of pipelines which we are using. Read XML, import SKU family, and other things. So to read XML log, these are the pipelines we need. First, we need to set the context. Okay. Then there is a requirement is like we need to create the item in a particular language. So here we need to support multi-site, right? Multi-language, multi-site. So we need to create like as per the what is the current feed. If one feed we need to support ENGP, another feed we need to support FRC and other things. So everything first we need to get it from like static. Here we need to in the template itself we mentioned, or we can read it from the XML itself. As of now, the XML if you see here, there is an attribute will be the what is the type of language. So this particular feed we will take, we will read it here, and this is the pipeline. What it will do is it will read the data and it will set the Sitecore language context of language, so that the whole Sitecore context language for the particular time till we reset that particular language item. Even though all the methods having a separate language parameter, we don't need to pass multiple places, so we are setting it one time. So the language context has been updated. Then post that what you are doing. There's one more activity also I'm trying, we are trying is like, even though we are targeting a particular node, if the node is too much, okay, there is one like use case we have seen like if the item is available in the database or not, right? So we can't able to hit the database each and every time, right? So when the pipeline is first created, we are creating the cache, we are writing a template. If you see here, what is the template ID in the pipeline batch? What are the templates the particular pipeline need to be processed, we need to mention. So that data we need to pass it, and we need to write one simple query, Sitecore query with the dissonance to take all the data and to store it in a memory cache. Okay, like kind of a dictionary key, template ID, list of values. So that cache will be used, that will be created only once for a particular iteration. Next time onwards, when next request is next particular node is reading, we will, instead of hitting the Sitecore, we will try to read from the cache itself, and we will take a call whether we need to create a new item or whether we need to update the item. Okay. Next is the one, this once the cache is created, then we need to read the XML, iterate the family one by one. Next, the mapping, this is the one here we are creating the Sitecore item. So this is the main pipeline. I'll show you the pipeline. So this is the main pipeline. What it will do is here only we are creating all the logics, like we are creating the item, updating the item, updating the workflow, everything. So first we need to resolve that parent. First we need to check for the particular parent is available or not. So we need to first take a call like where to create the item in the content tree, right? First we need to check this particular item is available, parent is available. That we will detect this is the item, this is a particular ID. We will pass this particular item ID. Not value, field ID to the Sitecore, and we will check whether the item is available. This is the way we are getting the attributes, and we are passing this XPath query, what we are getting from the template, and we are taking the list of IDs from the Sitecore already we have taken, and we are checking the item is available. If it is available, we are returning back true or false here. Then we need to check the actual item what you are going to create. It is available in the Sitecore. Next check. So then we will take a call. There are two methods in Sitecore supports. One is that item model dot create and item model dot update. So this is the method, Sitecore default method, repository dot create is the method. What we need to pass is like what is that item name, and what is the type of template, and what is the parent template. If you are passing, Sitecore DXF is having their own item structure. It is not using Sitecore item, it is using item model. Okay. So the item model is the one, because it is a it is not tightly coupled with Sitecore. It is having their own model so that you can able to convert the data to other structure. So it is not mandatory that you need to always using this module. You can able to import the data to the Sitecore. You can always use this separate module to import the data to other systems also, like Salesforce. I have not tried it, but Sitecore says like it is like Sitecore 9 onwards, like they are like not tightly coupled with Sitecore. Using this module, you can able to take data from anywhere and you can able to convert the data. Only what you need to do is you need to write your own converter and you need to write your own processor. So basic framework they are giving, we need to write our custom code, we need to extract. So now at least you guys got some basic thing. Come back to the slide.
Does it support the item bucketing? Let's say I have 10,000 articles under one domain, but internally I want to create item buckets like day, month, year, month, day. Can we create that way? You need to identify parent item, right?
So the parent item we need to set as a bucket, right? Under the parent item, if you are creating item, item.create, if you are targeting the particular item, Sitecore default functionality will take care, right? It will create as a bucket only. So the parent item should be marked as a bucket. You don't need to write any explicit code like to create a bucket, right? Okay, so this is the thing we discussed. If you see here, okay, so we discussed about the endpoint. If you see, I showed you what is endpoint. We have two different endpoints. This is the sample kind of query, what we need to set. Okay, and the target endpoint is a Sitecore by default one, so you don't need to mention anything. So by default, the Sitecore will take care. And what is value accessor set? So value accessor set is the one like I showed you, like we need to mention what is the source XPath and what is the target Sitecore field. So this is the sample query of the source endpoint, like you need to target a particular attribute or you need to target a field value. And we need to write a converter, any field type, you need to create your own converter, like image, you need to create a converter. What a converter means, like to read the particular field values in DXF what you guys mentioned, right? And the writer is the one which is responsible to update the value of the particular field. It won't create any item save even. It will update in the field value and it put it in the memory. Okay. Item event save event will be triggered only once for a particular product. How many attributes they have? It will be created at the pipeline which I showed you. Like repository.create is a pipeline which will trigger the item save event. Till that pipeline is called, everything will be like the model of the item model value will be keep updating. And I have shown you a list of pipelines, we need to like setting the language context, how to read the XML, and how to resolve the item to Sitecore. There is a pipeline. And we can create, as per their need, like you can create as much as a pipeline you want. And these are the two methods, create and update methods, as the one by default Sitecore provides. So this has multiple methods, if you see like version. So this version, like there is one of the use case I showed you, right, how to create a new version. So what we have done is like we are taking the current version. Okay, we are checking what is the workflow state. If it is a approved state, we are taking the version, what is the count. Let's take an example, the version count is 5 and we are incrementing by 1. And if you are passing the 6 to the particular update method, it will automatically create the new version. So this version parameter is an optional one. You need to pass it or you don't need to pass it. It is not really mandatory. And create is a method, like you need to pass the item name, what is the template ID, what is the kind of template the item need to be created, and the what is the parent ID, where the item need to be created, and what is the language. So language, so there is the one I'm telling, like each all the methods, language parameter is there. So if you are passing language parameter in each and every place, it's tough to maintain. So instead of that, like we thought of creating the separate pipeline, read one time, set once. So when the Sitecore context is set to a particular language, we don't need to explicitly mention what is the type of language. And logs. Okay, so by default, so this is the one. Logger, like we are overriding the default log. What is that? Sitecore has supports, like DXF supports the prefix Sitecore log. So we need some more extra information for to debug more or like to analyze what kind of data got processed and our settings, we created our own logs and we overdone the Sitecore. We passed the Sitecore things. And there are like by default Sitecore supports like warning. These are the methods like warning, error, pattern, info. So same, just we inherited the things, we overridden and put our own logic, what kind of data we need to log, what is the timestamp, all the things we overridden. So I'll show you one demo. So I have a home node. Under that I have a three level of categories, okay, stories. So under stories currently there is no data. So I'm going to so this is a small demo. Like if you see here under home, we have a couple of categories. So under stories there is no data. So I'm going to start execution. So I'll expand this. Okay, for DXF, you want to import the data, you need to go for the pipeline batches. And if you click the pipeline batch in the ribbon, you will get a separate node. Run pipeline batch. So, yeah. So this is XML. Okay, I have three load of products. Okay, so this product will create under this category, under storage category, and this dual SKU product will be created under this product, and these two products will be created under dual SKU, and this particular product having a reference of already I have some dummy products, these two products. So once I import, the product should be created in the appropriate category and the linking should be proper. So when you click on the pipeline batch, okay, you will get a, in the ribbon you will get a data exchange, there is a separate node will be there. So you need to click on this. Okay, this is a manual activity, but in real time scenario, just for a demo I was using this. In real time scenario it's tough to click maintain, click manually and do the things, right? So we are doing something like a kind of a scheduler. Like the scheduler, we will pass that this pipeline batch ID, we return a controller. So the controller like Sitecore DXF return like methods, we can initiate through programmatically also. So we will pass that item ID, pipeline batch item ID, and we will initiate through code only. So every 3 hours or 4 hours, we will get a delta field, and that pipeline will be automatically triggered and it will process the data, and based on our code logic, it will take a call whether we need to create or update, or we have option for deletion also. So let's run this.
It doesn't show any progress bar.
There is that you can't able to see, okay, that we can able to see, but that is has a limitation that is just to show only 1000 characters. I will show you in the log. If you see here, okay, the configuration we given is under this particular node, we have a feed folder. So whatever like how many XMLs we are updating here, all the XMLs will be processed alphabetically and it will process the data one by one. So we can able to see that there is a log folder. This is the one I was telling, we have customized it. So if you see here, So if you see here, you can able to see like pipeline batch starter and the starter processing this file. If you, this is the path we are trying to read the file. It found that 32 distinct items and it is resolved to the particular parent ID. Result to the particular parent ID means whatever the item we are going to create, it will create under this, and this child attribute is created. So here we can able to identify like what are the items got created, imported properly, and we were logging like if item is not created, like we are logging this parent ID is not resolved or value has some corrupted data, everything can able to identify. And there is one more log file is a detail log. So detail log is the one, it will have a full details about the pipeline exceptions, like if there is any exception, each and every pipeline, how much time it took, is there is any exception, what are the pipelines got initiated, what are the pipeline completed successfully, what are the pipelines failed, everything is logged here. See item, it is item is resolved. Resolve here, it is attributes we are trying to resolve, this is the pipeline, map, attribute units, everything we are doing. So let's see, okay, so item got created. If you see, previously storage is empty, under storage we have a item got created, okay, and so I pass the languages CNGB, right, I showed in XML. So if you see the language item is created under ENGB version. So whatever the language we want, we just need to pass it. So this all the data is imported. See, this item is created dynamically and whatever the data we are seeing, everything is reading from the XML. So as I told you, like there is a, we have done, so this is a thing we have done on our own. So we have a couple of products and it is pre-populated. So why DXF is mainly we are using is, already client is using some system product thing. So after importing, we are asking client to go and do the enrichment manually. It is a pain for client, right? So we have to reduce their effort as much as possible. So we need to extend like how much we can able to do the enrichment through our code.
This is specific to project openings, right? Based on project, a lot of customization required.
It's not customization, it is like you're writing your own pipeline. See, this that's what I saw. When I'm starting itself, it is not very specific to your particular template type or field name. Okay, we are targeting Sitecore default field type. What is that image? Multilist. Yes, already things are there.
So same thing we can do is we can create one schedule, right?
Based on your project need, right? See, that's what, by default, you need to just create, by default, you don't need to write a single pipeline. If you are having a plain data, you need to just import name, description, something, plain data. You need to just mention what is the XPath query, okay? And what is the field name? It will import automatically. And why we need this tool? The question for you is, Sitecore is default giving some framework. So it don't want like you, see, it's a business, right? Sitecore don't want to you as a client like go back to some other third party companies or like we have a lot of SXA framework like BrainJobs and other things. There are some companies they started utilizing, so when they're used to it, like they will come back to Sitecore like minimal, right? So they want to engage more. So by default, they are giving some of the frameworks. Okay, you can use this and you won't extend as per your need. No, it is a sample. See, it is a provider. So if you see that SUG, there is one more demo is happened that is on Excel sheet. It's a plain demo. So you can able like tomorrow, you can able to take this data from another Sitecore instance. Let's take an example. There is a client you are going to work. They are using Sitecore 7.2. You want to migrate to Sitecore 9.1. Okay. One of three, you need to write your own source and target providers.
You can take from data is
everything is a provider. See, it is what we have done is a extra simple class to read parse the data, right? Same like that, you need to write a pipeline to read that online service or something, put it in item model so that again we need to write a provider, convert the item model to a Sitecore.
So you said these are not the actual items.
No, these are all normal Sitecore items. So DXF, if you see, in Sitecore world, everything we call it as a Sitecore context or item, right? But in DXF, we are calling it as an item model. Okay? So item model by default, some standard fields they are giving. Okay? Standard values, default field and all, it won't come. You can able to go and update in the item model, but you can't able to read in the item model. Okay, so they are telling like this is a unique object for this particular framework. Use this object and extend as per your need. What is the source? What's the target?
So when you are running production, right? Example, if you want to import some laptops, so how stable is this running for few hours and working or continuously?
So we tried around 800 products. Okay, 800 products means one product is having around 100 attributes, 50 to 100 attributes means roughly 8000 items, Sitecore item, typical items. It processing around 4 hours. 80,000. It around process 4 hours, but still we are working on the performance improvement, like how, what are the different, we are working with Sitecore, how to improve more to reduce that importing time. So only the first time, the number of records will be more, right? So real-time scenario, delta feed and all, you are not expecting like more than some hundreds.